Lesson, working with methods. Lesson overview. Many new functions are delivered with the SAP standard version as classes or methods. This lesson will provide you with a short introduction into object-oriented programming, and then show you how you can find existing classes and methods in the SAP system and how you can use them from within your program. The basic syntax elements of ABAP objects are explained using a SAP standard class. This standard class serves to call up the SAP list viewer. You can use this to display an internal table on a screen in graphic form. Business example. So you want to use the standard functions in your program that are encapsulated in global classes. Working with global classes and methods. To be able to use the classes and methods that exist in the SAP system, we must first understand some basic terms used in object-oriented programming. Let's start with classes and objects. A class is a formal description of objects or instances. At runtime, you can create several instances of a class, all of which have their own attributes and methods. You can access corresponding attributes of an instance by calling an instance method. Classes can be defined either locally within a program or globally in the class library. SAP has shipped, with the standard version, many global classes with methods that encapsulate the required functions for reusability. Hence, these classes and methods also belong to the reuse components. As a hint, global classes can be found using the standard search tool SAP application hierarchy and repository info system. So, this is very useful when you are programming for a specific application component and you want a class or methods that do something that you want to program. Instead of doing it from scratch or from zero, you can search for the corresponding class. Let's take a look at the standard classes inside SAP. So, SAP delivers a standard class library that you can use and implement in your programs. So, in order to go to that library, we navigate to the Object Navigator. And it's taking a while. There you go. Inside the Object Navigator, you can click on the Repository Information System. And then you can navigate to the Class Library. In the Class Library, you can look for classes, methods, if you know the name of a method, specific attributes, events, or types. Let's take a look at the classes. So, in this tool, you have to specify the name of a class or a package. You want to look the classes for a specific package if you know the name of a package. If you don't know any of those, you can just run the program and then it will display all of the classes in the SAP system. Let's take a look, for example, at the classes that start with CL underscore GUI, and I place an asterisk because I want all the classes that start with that string. So I run my program and then it displays me all of the classes that contain the CL underscore GUI prefix. So for example, I can take a look at the class for the ALV list viewer, double click, using forward navigation, and then I can take a look at the methods that this class offers to me and how I can use them. If I want to know the parameters, for example, of the method assigned property, I select the method and I click on parameter. And then it shows the parameters for this method. They are importing parameters, they pass value, and they are not optional. So it is obligatory that you assign these parameters whenever you use this method. Let's go back to the method, and that way you can navigate to the class and look for a method that you need. Let's go back again. And let's go back again. So this is the first way to look at the class library. There's another way to look at the class library, or another way to search for classes that you need. So let's go back to the object navigator, to the ABAP development workbench, and we click on environment, application hierarchy, and we can take a look at the SAP or the customer. This time we want to take a look at the SAP. And inside the application components, I can search classes for specific components. For example, if I want the classes for the financial component, I can look at here. If I want the payroll classes, I can take a look at this and navigate through the three. Let's take a look, for example, at the basis components. There are some very useful libraries and classes that we're going to use in the basis component. For example, let's scroll down. And we are going to scroll to the BC-SRV component. We're going to be working a lot with the classes in this component. They're very useful. VCSRV, and we open. And then we take a look at the SAP List Viewer component. And inside, we navigate to the package SLIS, the generic list types. We double click using forward navigation. Remember, in most of the windows you can double click to navigate. And inside the list package we can take a look at the class library, the classes that it offers, and then we can take a look, for example, at the CLALV_grid, for example. The class to create an ALV grid. We're going to talk later on what is an ALV grid. Just keep in mind that ALVs are very used in SAP, a lot. You use ALVs almost everywhere inside the SAP system. So it is very useful to know about this class, so you can take a look at the methods of the class. And this is using the application hierarchy. So you can choose either of those to navigate through the different classes that SAP offers you. Creating objects and calling methods. As instances do not have names, you have to define reference variables in order to be able to generate and address instances of classes. Reference variables are defined using the ABAP keyword statement data, then the reference name, type ref2, and then the class name. Then you use the create object, and then you specify a reference name statement, and this creates an instance of the class that was specified in the definition of the reference variables. Afterwards, the reference variable points to the newly created instance. So first you declare the reference name or the instance using the type ref2 and then the class name, and then you initiate that class using the create object and the reference name you declared before. When you use create object, you might have to supply the import parameters of the special method constructor with data. You call methods of an instance using the statement call method, the reference name or the instance of the class, dash, arrow, and the method name. In contrast to calling a function model, the method name alone does not suffice here. You have to specify the relevant instance as well, as it is possible that the program has several instances of that class. Now, example of standard classes. The classes of the enjoy SAP controls. SAP has shipped many enjoy SAP controls with which you can design screens more ergonomically and interestingly. For example, the grid control. The class CL_GUI_ALV_grid. It was the class that we were looking at the system earlier. So this class is to display an internal table on a screen with many interesting functions such as sort, filter, and totals. So remember, we've been working with internal tables, and now we can display them to the screen in a very friendly way with interesting functions such as sort, filter, and totals. Then we have the picture control. That is the class CL_GUI_picture to display a picture on the screen. We have the HTML viewer control. The class CL_GUI_HTML_viewer, and this class is used to display a HTML file or web page on the screen. So you see, you can add pictures using the corresponding class, and you can even display an HTML file or a web page on a SAP screen. And the tree control class is to depict a hierarchical list in the form of a tree structure on the screen, just as the trees we navigate to look at the classes. The tree controls are very useful to organize objects.